Yeah, no stopping the fire. Still fighting through the shit that made house and retire. Most of y'all only tough when you watching the wire. But start to perspire when your fingers on the table. And I got the pliers, should take them away. That's what these uncreative labels and haters to say. Cause I be ripping up the flows like a paper mache. Giving out the free mix for people not able to pay. Ayo, but touche, I'm never falling off like a Lupe. Star player, I ain't got time for Bobby Boucher's. I am here to stay, the leader of the new age. Investors with toupees, no money in my suitcase. I don't care what you say. If you don't like what I say, the sumé. I'm still dropping every other Tuesday. Flyer than a Blue Jay, sharper than Blu-ray. Cooler than Cool J, I'm sweeter than some Kool-Aid. I got a hit list, I'll write your name. With this pen, rewrite the game. Me and y'all just not the same. I guess I should've won. I'm gonna be forever. I'm never going down in flames. I'm hardly ever sober. But the high was light of pain. So they calling me a pop figure. But truth be told, I'm a schmurder, I'm a hot nigga. I tried to tell them I'm from right up off the block with ya. And I'm just trying to stay away from all the cop triggers. So sayonara, you diabolical imitations from my inner sanctum. I'm engineering this innovation. The only person to take that emotion from in the basement and indicate that I'm ready for radio syndication. I see y'all waiting and thanks again for your patience. Fuck these intricate statements, I'm trying to get back to basics. Counting presidents' faces was never ever the basis. But I must have stumbled into a bakery cause I'm taking now.
Yo, what is going on, you guys? It's Ninja here, and today what I have for you guys is going to be a pretty cool video. Today, I want to showcase every single specialist for their hero gear. Now, I know a lot of you guys, if you go for Dark Matter, once you're done with Dark Matter, I'd probably say a lot of people then go for the hero gear. And in today's video, I want to showcase all 9 specialists, and also while I'm showcasing every single one, I want to give you guys tips as far as game modes and stuff like that to how to get the hero gear a lot faster, and just kind of things that I did to really improve myself on each specialist character. So for you guys, let's kind of jump straight into the first, and like let's go through all like 9 of these. Every single one of these, you guys, I'm gonna give you guys tips on. So this video may be a little bit longer, but if you guys want to skip through it, I don't really care. If you guys want to go to the particular ones you guys may be having troubles with, I just wanted to just really show you guys the hero gear and also just give you guys some tips on how to like improve yourselves with each hero gear or just each person in general. So for you guys, let's kind of just jump straight into the first one. So you guys, here we have it. I'm gonna use the gravity spikes person, and let's kind of showcase the gravity spikes guy. So the head is the overdrive and the body gear is then the gravity spikes, or it might be flipped around, it really doesn't matter to be honest. But this is what he looks like in full hero gear. Look how cool he looks right there. That just looks so sick. I think this character in general looks really cool. If you look at him like that, it's a little bit laggy right now, but it still honestly looks pretty cool. Now you guys, for as far as gravity spikes, if you guys are having troubles with this, if me personally, I think this was one of the hardest ones I was having the most trouble with, because once you actually get here, let's go to the action to show you guys. So once you actually get like the classified one to actually be able to unlock the hero gear, it says kill 6 enemies in a game with gravity spikes 6 times, and that is so hard, you guys. Killing someone with 6 times in a game with gravity spikes is pretty difficult. So the game mode that I would recommend, domination, hardpoint, safeguard is pretty good as far as if you were like a 6-man party and stuff like that. I think honestly that one was probably my hardest one to achieve, just because 6 gravity spike kills in a single game is very difficult. But you guys, that is pretty much wrapping up the gravity spikes person. That was honestly one of the most difficult ones I could probably say. Next we have the overdrive. I think honestly, me personally, I think the overdrive was very simple. I honestly got this done in like 2 games or something like that. The game modes I would recommend, domination, TDM, honestly it doesn't really matter, because it, like literally look at this, kill 4 enemies in a game while using overdrive, or when overdrive is active, 4 times, and that's actually pretty simple. Overdrive actually like charges up pretty quickly too, so it's like that one is actually pretty simple. I don't think I really need to explain that one too much. Now guys, let's go into the next character. Now we have the Outrider character. This is the Sparrow. Let's like kind of showcase that one a little bit. So this is what this one looks like. He looks, or she looks, pretty cool. I wouldn't say this is the best out of them all. I think it looks like decent. I would probably say it's one of the worst out of the 9, but I still think it looks kind of cool. And let's kind of go straight into the Sparrow one and explain a little bit of this. So you guys, the Sparrow one was actually still pretty difficult, but I still found this pretty easy. As far as how this one worked, kill 6 enemies in the game with 6 or with the Sparrow 6 times. How I really worked with that one was using domination, using game modes as far as like really long game modes. I would recommend like really long game modes. That's all you really have to. And I'm gonna probably repeat myself with that with a lot of these characters, because a lot of these characters you need to use the ability a lot within the game to actually get the hero gear and stuff like that. So it says kill 6 enemies in a game with the Sparrow 6 times. Like I said before, domination, game modes like that, game modes that really go long, that's probably the best ones that I could recommend. Now going into the headgear, this is the Vision Pulse. Vision Pulse is actually pretty simple. If you guys play hardcore a lot, I think the Vision Pulse helped me out a lot in hardcore. Also in free for all, I use this a lot and I think it helped me a lot. And also domination, I think honestly helps out every single hero gear and stuff like that. So that is wrapping up the Outrider character. Let's go into the third character. So the third one, you guys, is the Prophet character. Here we have the Tempest, here we have the Glitch. Let's kind of showcase this guy a little bit. He looks pretty cool overall. I think he honestly looks one of the best out of the 9. That's just my personal opinion. Let's go into the Tempest and kind of explain this one up a little bit. So it says kill 6 enemies in a game with the Tempest 6 times. That one was actually still pretty difficult, but like I said before, domination, longer game modes helps out a lot with this character. A lot of these guys, the tip that I can give you is if you guys can play with full man parties, so where you guys can almost dominate the game, to where you guys can be like, okay, don't grab the B flag, let's kind of just protect it, no one grab it, let's make this game go a little bit longer. Same goes with Safeguard and stuff like that. I found Safeguard actually help a lot with a lot of these specialists, because if you can have a buddy or two buddies or maybe even a 6-man party and you guys can really control the whole game, you can really make that game go really, really long. And that's where I think the hero gear is very important. As far as if you're with parties and stuff like that, I think hero gear is a lot more simple to go for. So guys, that's wrapping up Tempest. Let's go into the Glitch character. So it says kill 4 enemies in a game shortly after using the Glitch 4 times. The Glitch actually, my personal opinion, is one of the best specialists in this game. Now the reason why I say that, you guys, is because the simple fact of you don't know how many times these specialists has saved me before. Like if someone is shooting you from their backside, usually you would die, but sometimes I would just hit the Glitch really quick and then I would spawn right behind him and kill him and stuff like that. So I think the Glitch honestly is one of the characters that I actually use, just my personal thing. Like I use it a lot. I think it's still pretty fun. So you guys, let's kind of go and just jump straight into the next character. I think this one is pretty simple overall. I think it's honestly one of the easier ones to go for. So guys, that is wrapping up the Prophet character. Let's go into the Battery character. We're halfway through this video, guys. Bear with me, I know this video is pretty long. I just wanted to really just get in depth with all these and really help a lot of people out. So first, you guys, let's kind of showcase this person a little bit. She looks pretty cool. I definitely like the helmet and I have a lot of good gestures for this chick. So I actually use the chick a lot. Now you guys, first, as far as the War Machine goes, this character was pretty hard for the War Machine, but like it wasn't super, super hard. Let me take that back. It wasn't super hard, but it was still kind of difficult, because the War Machine, the thing that I don't like about it is it doesn't blow up with direct impact. Like how the War Machine works, it almost like hits the ground, bounces once, and then blows up. So that's why I don't really like the War Machine too much, but I still think in domination kind of game modes like that, it helps me out the most. Now going into the next one, you guys, that one is pretty much simple. It's like self-explanatory. Just go into the longer game modes, kind of shoot down the B flags and stuff like that. That's where I really mainly find a lot of kills. Like if the enemy is capping the B flag, you can just shoot one over there, maybe get like a double kill or triple kill or something like that. That has actually happened to me quite a bit. Now going to the headgear, you guys, this is the kinetic armor. Now this one was super, super easy for me. Guys, the game mode that I can highly recommend with this one is hardcore domination. If you guys are playing with a 6-man, this is so simple, you guys. Or if you're playing by yourself in hardcore domination, I actually grinded this one out pretty quickly. Like I think in 2 games I got this one. Kill 4 enemies in a game while using kinetic armor, and it is also active 4 times. So that one's pretty simple, you guys. Let's go straight into the 5th character, and this one is the I don't really know even how to say that one. Surfeit, whatever, it doesn't really matter. I'm not good with words, you guys. Here we have the Annihilator. Overall, I think this one was the first one that I actually like got hero gear with. As you guys see right there, there's the M27. If you guys want to see that video, that is actually in one of my recent videos to how to get the M27 as your showcased weapon. Let's go into like the Annihilator. The Annihilator, it says kill 6 enemies in game with the Annihilator 6 times. Obviously, like I said before, guys, longer game modes, that helps that out a lot. Domination, hardpoint, safeguard, those games are very, very good. Going into the next one, you guys, here we have the Combat Focus. It says earn 4 score streaks in the game while using combat focus 4 times. This one was pretty simple. I use combat focus quite a bit. Just like I said before, domination, longer type of game modes works out a lot and just helps you out a lot with that one. Going into the next character, you guys, this is the Nomad character. Here we have the Hive, we have the Reject. Let's showcase this one up a little bit. This one looks pretty cool. I would probably say it's one of the worst though. It still looks cool in my opinion, but it's probably one of the worst out of the 9 because there's just so many good options out as far as like the 9 specialist characters. But you guys, the Hive, the recommended kind of thing that I could say to you guys is kill 6 enemies in game with the Hive 6 times. The game modes, like I said, domination. Honestly, my personal opinion, I think domination helps out a lot for getting all of these hero gears. That's just me though. And I honestly just take my tips, you guys. I've gotten all the hero gear. I can really just explain all of these and help you guys out a lot. So the Hive, you guys, is definitely a difficult one. The thing that I would really recommend with the Hive when you guys do play sit down is really throw them all in one spot. Like if you're like, let's say like an enemy captures a C-Flay in combine, what I'd recommend is literally just like just molest an area with Hives. Like just go insane with like just hive all next to each other, because the thing that I found out that worked the best for me was a lot of times when like a couple teammates would be running at the same like in the same like house or whatever, it'd be like one guy dies, the next guy dies, and then the next guy dies, if you guys kind of get what I'm saying. So that means you need 3 Hives in that like same position. So that's really what I did. I would just like load up one room with the Hive, and that's where I found getting like a lot of kills really like really quickly. Now going into the next one, you guys, this is killing 4 enemies with Reject 4 times. This one is actually pretty hard, but like just because so many people like know how like Nomad and Reject works like right now, like a lot of people do this. Like when I'm in Reject, they'll go behind me and then they'll just punch me the second I kind of go up because I can't actually see them from behind me. So Reject was pretty difficult, but I think Nuketown honestly made this very simple. Like, and when I did Nuketown, I got this very quickly. And just going into all of these specialist characters, you guys, I found Nuketown actually helped me out like a lot. Like if you have a 24/7 playlist going on or like a double XP weekend, I would recommend just really grinding out Nuketown and stuff like that with all of these hero gears, because you'll get them so quickly. And that's really how I found like getting the hero gear pretty quickly. Now going into the Reaper, we have 3 more to go, you guys, just bear with me here. We have the Reaper. Now let's go into the Scythe a little bit. So it says kill 6 enemies in a game with the Scythe. Let's actually first showcase this specific specialist person, because I didn't really showcase it yet. This one actually looks pretty cool in my like this is probably like the 2nd or 3rd best one. I just really like how he has like the red eyes and stuff like that. He just looks like a super cool robot. But you guys, this one says kill 6 enemies in a game with the Scythe 6 times. That one was actually pretty simple. Domination, like if you can spawn trap, use like the Hater and stuff like that. That's where I really found this one to work a lot, like really, really good with me. Going to the next one, you guys, kill 4 enemies in game while using Psychosis when it is active 4 times. The game modes that I recommend, like I said, Dom, all those game modes, those help out a lot with this one too. The thing that I really found out about this one too, if you guys go into a spawn, like if you're going into C-Flag, A-Flag, whatever, the thing that I really would recommend is right when you are about to just jump right into that spawn, hit this, let your characters run out a little before you, and then when you see enemies shooting at those characters, maybe they're on the radar, they don't have a suppressor, then run out there, you guys, and just start shooting them. The thing with this one is you have to have patience. That is what I learned. You have to have patience a little bit. You have to let your Psychosis people do the work a little bit, and then when you see the enemy shooting at the Psychosis, that is when you get your prey, you guys, and you will see that actually works out a lot. So guys, that is the Reaper character. Let's go into the Spectre character. This one was pretty fun, you guys. I like this one actually quite a bit. Like look at this one, this just looks like a ninja. Get it, you guys, Ghost Ninja. This one was probably one of the easier ones. Kill 6 enemies in a game with the Ripper 6 times. This one, you guys, you will have to use Nuketown or Combine or really just small maps and stuff like that, because I found really big maps, killing 6 enemies with a Ripper is very difficult. So I would just really try to get really small maps. Make sure you guys are playing core. I would highly recommend it. I wouldn't recommend hardcore and stuff like that, because when you're knifing, you actually have like a little bit of a lunge and stuff like that. So I'd recommend like just doing core and stuff like that when you're going for the Ripper character. Now going to the second one, you guys, here's the headgear. It says kill 4 enemies in a game shortly after breaking out of the active camo. This one was pretty simple. Like I said before, it's a Psychosis. You have to be patient with this one. Maybe there's an enemy in front of you when you're activating this, but the thing that I've recommended to all of you guys is just be really patient. Like if you see one enemy in front of you and think maybe more are going to be coming, just give it a second, because I've really found out that when you give it a second, there'll actually be more enemies like running right past the other enemies, so then you can get right behind them while you're invisible and just shoot all all the enemies right in front of you, and it's actually very simple to get this. And just getting 4 kills in a game after breaking out of the active camo 4 times is actually pretty simple. And going into the next one, you guys here are actually, we already kind of explained the Ripper. So you guys, that is the Spectre character. Let's go into our final and 9th specialist. So here we have the Firebreak, and let's kind of showcase this one a little bit. This one looks pretty cool. I like the mask with it and stuff like that, and I like the little jetpack and stuff on the back of it, or technically it's like the purifier, fire thing or whatever. Here we have the purifier. Let's go into it and kind of explain a little bit. So here it says kill 6 enemies a game with the purifier 6 times. This one was very simple, you guys. The game mode that I recommend, Domination, highly recommend Domination, because when all the enemies spawn right in their air flags, the thing that with this one, you have to spray, you guys. Don't give it a, if you see an enemy, or if you're about to run around a corner, just start spraying if you think there might be an enemy. Because the thing that I found about this is a lot of the times, when you hit your enemy, you'll get a couple hit markers before they die, and while you're actually getting hit markers on them, they can actually still kill you. So the thing is, you really need to get these off pretty quickly. Right when you go around a corner, just start spraying it, you guys, and I think that will help out the best. Going to the next one, you guys, here's the headgear. Kill 4 enemies in game when they're stunned by the heat wave 4 times. This one is actually very simple. Play Domination, play Nuketown. I actually got this one quite quickly. As far as the heat wave and stuff like that, there's really no recommended tips with it. Just really play Domination and just try to get behind people and stuff like that. Really just flank a lot of people with the heat wave. And when you can get behind people, that is when this heat wave, you can get so many kills. When people are camping in a house, maybe 2-3 of them, just go behind them, hit the heat wave real quick. You'll get 3 kills right there, right off the bat. And that's actually very simple. So you guys, that is pretty much going to be wrapping up today's video. I hope you guys did all enjoy. And if you guys did, please drop a like button. And if you guys are new to the channel, please subscribe. I know this video was very long, and it was pretty hard for me to make this video just because I've been talking for so long. If you guys wanted me to do any more hero gear tips or anything in specific, just let me know down in the comment section down below. Also, you guys can see over on the right side, the little calling card right there. That is because I actually mastered all of the hero gear and stuff like that. I actually really do like that because it moves and stuff like that and changes specialists and stuff like that. But you guys, I hope this video did all help you guys. If you guys did, like I said before, drop a like on the video because this video was definitely pretty hard for me to make. And also, grinding for the hero gear and stuff like that was very difficult. And I know a lot of people, after they're done with the grind with Dark Matter, go on to the hero gear and stuff like that. So today, I hope you all did enjoy, and peace out.